the 71st and 72nd stars on the Walk of Fame. The Walk of Fame is a project of the Nashville Convention and Visitors Corporation Foundation, Music City, Inc. But of course, it wouldn't be possible without all our great sponsors. We want to recognize our founding sponsor, Gibson Guitar. A round of applause to Henry Guskowitz and his crew. He's the CEO of Gibson, the entire Gibson family, for their support. We also recognize the Hilton Nashville downtown, Made First, Coca-Cola, and that guitar slinger right there, David Anderson, for their continued support. I want to introduce to my right on the stage and start by saying a special thank you to Mayor Megan Barry and her staff for their support today. Seated next to her, Christy Smith, the chair of the Metro Parks Board of Directors. We couldn't do this event without the help of the Parks Board and staff, certainly. And we also have Beth Courtney with us, who is the chair-elect of the board for the Nashville Convention and Visitors Corporation, who's joined by CEO Butch Spiridon, down on the end there. The NCDC staff produces this great event for the city, and we thank you all for your efforts. Since the first induction ceremony, Music City has celebrated a diverse group of artists, from Reba to Little Richard. And it was so cold that day, and I still hear his immortal words. Shut up, Bill! I'm freezing! The Fisk Jubilee Singers, Kings of Leon, we've celebrated singers, songwriters, producers, conductors, business executives, musicians, and each of these individuals have one thing in common. They've each had a creative impact on Music City and our wonderful musical heritage. Today's honorees are no exception. Alabama's Randy Owen, Teddy Gentry, and Jeff Cook, and Sam Moore. Their careers, their accomplishments, and their contributions have been immeasurable to Nashville, Tennessee. And to help honor them, would you welcome our mayor, Megan Barry.
Great to be with all of you here. Bill was actually the MC for my first State of Metro address a couple of weeks ago over at the amphitheater, and that's one of Nashville's newest music venues, and we love it. I wanted to give a special shout out to some of the other elected officials who are here with us today. We have State Representative Harold Love, Love in the House over here. We have Councilman Robert Swope, and we have Council Member Devette Blaylock, both right here. And although he's not elected, he is leading up a great project for us right now. We have Henry Hicks, who is the CEO of the National Museum of African American Music, with us also today, Henry. I want to thank Butch and his team at the Convention and Visitors Bureau for all that they do for Walk of City, the Music City Walk of Fame and the ceremony. And I also want to welcome all of you who are in here and all of you who are out there today, whether you live in Nashville or whether you're just visiting to our Walk of Fame Park, welcome. It's one of my favorite places in the city. And let me tell you why. It's because it's one of those few places that you all can walk around and soak in all this great music that has come out of Nashville. And we are known as Music City because music actually inspires and invigorates Nashville. And you see it all around us. You see it in the songwriters, the musicians, the producers, the conductors, the managers, the executives, the publishers, the engineers, the tour managers, the publicists, the stagehands, and the designers. They all work and live and play here every day. And if you take a quick stroll around Walk of Fame Park over here, you're gonna see all that diversity of the talent that we have in Nashville. You're gonna see Dolly Parton. You're gonna see CeCe Winans. You're gonna see Kid Rock, Johnny Cash, Jack White, and Loretta Lynn. And the location of the park also keeps that story going, because we are right here. If you take a moment, you can see we're right here by the Scummerhorn, which is right behind us, which is the home of our Grammy-winning symphony. You've got Bridgestone Arena behind me, which is also recognized as one of the best concert venues in America. And you've got the iconic Country Music Hall of Fame right over here, which celebrates our great musical beginnings. So take a walk and have a chance to see all those, because we have a really powerful recipe. And there are a whole lot of mayors out there who would love to get their hands on what Nashville does. The depth of our community, the diversity, the collaboration, the spirit that drives so much of the joy that comes from our music makes Nashville truly Music City. And I am grateful in the unique way that we get to honor all these individuals, like the folks who are sitting up here today on this stage. And I can tell you that there are no more two deserving acts than the two that we have with us right now. The great soul singer, Sam Moore, and the amazing country group, Alabama. Early in his career, Sam spent a lot of time in a certain city that's a few hours west of here that we're not gonna name. But he has recently been a tremendous friend to Nashville. He's given freely of his time to help spread the word about our great music culture, and he's become a regular performer throughout our city. And Sam, just to paraphrase, I thank you. Now, I can't sing, but I'm just gonna paraphrase it. One of your biggest hits, you didn't have to love us like you did, but you did. But you did. And we thank you. So thank you, Sam. And Alabama, not only did you excel in country music, but your music is actually what catapulted the genre to the mainstream. And you are really one of the first bands that brought Nashville to the world. And 3 decades later, you are still singing. In fact, y'all just sang last week over there. And even though Nashville is a ways away from the mountains, I think one of the lyrics in mountain music perfectly captures what happens here every single day. And I can't sing this one either, but you'll know it, and you can hum along. Play some back home, come on music that comes from the heart. Play something with lots of feeling, because that's where music has the start. So, Sam Moore, Alabama, you have brought so much feeling to your music for so many of us for so many years now. So Sam and Jeff, Teddy and Randy, let me congratulate you on this well-deserved honor, and to thank you for all you have done for our great city, Nashville. Thank you.
She's got command of lyrics. She had Peter Frampton at her State of the Metro address, and she was up there singing every word with him. Thank you, Mayor Barry. Our first inductee is the legendary soul man himself, Mr. Sam Moore. Sam earned this title being the tenor voice of the Grammy-winning duo Sam and Dave, whose iconic hit Soul Man sold more than 10 million records worldwide. And the duo, they had many more remarkable songs. Hold On, I'm Coming, I Thank You, Soul Sister. While known for R&B, Sam has collaborated with artists of all genres, including Zac Brown, Jon Bon Jovi, Vince Gill, Sting, and Conway Twitty. In fact, his collaboration with Conway, Rainy Night in Georgia, was the last recording of Conway's career. Sam is one of Nashville's most enthusiastic advocates, elevating the Music City brand and showcasing the diversity of music that calls Nashville home. He's performed at so many conventions to sell the city, played at the Music City Food and Wine Festival. Earlier this year, he was able to fulfill a lifelong dream when he performed with the Fisk Jubilee Singers at a special celebration in their honor. Sam has been inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, has been named one of the top 100 greatest singers of all time. That was by Rolling Stone magazine. Here to present Sam Moore is a performer who's been called the Rolls Royce of country singers. And I get to share the stage with her at the Grand Ole Opry, where she celebrates 50 years of membership. 11 Grammy Award nominations, 20 top 10 Billboard country singles, and 31 charting albums, three of which hit number one throughout her incredible career. Would you welcome the great Connie Smith?
You'd think after all that, that Bill had said everything there was to say about Sam Moore, but I think Sam Moore is just getting started. He is an all-encompassing singer. He's actually been voted by the Rolling Stone as one of the top 100 singers of all time. Don't you agree? Member of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame and a member of the Vocal Group Hall of Fame and a member of the Grammy Hall of Fame, you would think that he would just go home. But Sam is, I mean, what else can you do? But if there's anything else that can be done, Sam's going to do it. Because that heart that's as big as a mountain and that voice that's as big as the waves of the ocean, he is something that is iconic just to watch. When he comes in a room, he brings joy with him. I love him very much, and I even heard him sing a George Jones country song with Marty Stewart. I love him too. But Sam is such a great singer, and the fact that he's still going and still creating and still loving everybody everywhere he goes, it's an honor for me to stand up here and to introduce him and to induct him to the into the walkway of stars in Nashville.
Sam, would you come here?
You know, any time that I'm getting an award, my wife, my publicist, even Connie, even her husband, they all start sneaking down in their seats because they don't know what I want to say. I'm a very nice person when you get to know me. I would fire my wife for what I've been doing for almost, 60 years, but you gotta understand, I have a tendency to forget words now when I sing. I start singing Soul Man and wind up singing, Hold On, I'm Coming. So I don't know what I'm... But I'd like to thank Butch and all everybody that has embraced me with this award. And I am more than happy, and it's a pleasure and an honor. I think it's almost complete now. Once I get Connie Smith to sing with me some gospel, it will be complete. So I want to ask you a question, then I'm going to leave. Can you see me?
Yes.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Thank you. Now I'm going to sit my butt down.
Butch Spirity with Sam Ward headed over to unveil his star on the Music City Walk of Fame. Media will gather, they'll take pictures. The three cousins, Jeff Cook, Teddy Gentry, Randy Owen from Fort Payne. They broke through the country scene with their first big hit. That was My Home's in Alabama. That was 1980. How many of you were teenagers in 1980? Show of hands, please. That tells us something. You're not a millennial. Country music hasn't been the same since. They brought their unique southern rock sound to Nashville and forever changed country music, bringing the genre into the mainstream. Teddy said, we were renegades in sneakers and t-shirts. We had long hair and we played loud. But it didn't take long for traditional country music enthusiasts to catch on to the new style. And Alabama has gone on to be one of the most noted acts in the history of country music. They built so much success in Nashville, 43 number one singles, 21 number one singles in a row. They won a staggering, listen to this, 178 CMA awards. As we approach the 50th anniversary of that event, some special things in conjunction with the Music City Walk of Fame. Grammy Awards, ACM Awards, 21 gold, platinum, multi-platinum albums, and were named RIAA's Country Group of the Century. Their hearts are as big as their hits. The group having raised more than $250 million for various charities throughout their career. That alone is worthy of Hall of Fame musicians. And their music has withstood the test of time. Even their earliest hits can still be heard pouring out of the clubs and honky-tonks all up and down Lower Broadway in Nashville. But with over three decades of record success, guess what? They're nowhere near being done. And that's for us as fans, that's the good news. They just released their latest album, Southern Drawl. It came out late last year, kicking off the North American leg of their Southern Drawl tour later this month. And to officially introduce Alabama into the Music City Walk of Fame, Koss Weaver is here. He's the head of BMG Records and Publishing in Nashville, the group's current label, and has more than 30 years in the music business, helping to develop some of the industry's biggest names. And Koss has worked with the iconic band on most of their recent work, and I want to bring him to the stage right now. Koss Weaver.
I got to tell you, I am incredibly honored and flattered to have been asked to be here. Not only to get to talk about these amazing guys over here on my left, but I dreamed of moving to this city, and I got to do that in the early 90s, and to be a part of a ceremony like this is just really special to me, and not to mention also I'm getting to sit next to Alabama and Sam Moore, if you haven't noticed. So this is an amazing day for me. I've had the good fortune to be at the helm of BMG Records in Nashville for a couple of years now, and our crowning achievement in my entire time there so far is we convinced the number one country band of all time to sign to us. So my bosses were very happy when I was able to sign these guys. And again, it's our biggest achievement we've had in our label, and we're so proud to be working with them. And so proud of this amazing new record that they've made, and it's just further proof of what an amazing band you guys are. If you've asked yourself, like I have, what it takes to be cemented into a walk of fame in a city that many consider to be the music center of the entire universe, I also consider it to be, no offense against some of our other music industry hubs, but Nashville is an incredibly special place. So if you're asking, how do you get enshrined in such a wonderful thing? All those amazing stats that Bill mentioned is a really good place to start. And I could literally sit here until, they start kicking drunks out of Tootsies down the street here, and with all the accolades that I could keep adding to what Bill mentioned, and they would go on for a long time. But I think I want to focus on what it took to get these guys to the point to where they are now. And that is a talent that God does not gift to everyone. These three men, as musicians, songwriters, and vocalists, are one of a kind. Do yourself a favor and attend one of their shows this summer, and you won't find a better example of what band harmony singing is all about than when they do Lady Down on Love with just the three of them. Have you heard of them do that, by the way, anybody out there? I've heard it many times. It's amazing, and I just get goosebumps every single time I hear it. It's an amazing song, and it's amazing performance. From their very humble beginnings, they didn't just rest on that talent. They paid their dues by slugging it out in places like the Bowery in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, for years and years playing for tips and living hand to mouth. Along with their willingness to work for it, they also had the heart to stand their ground and to be who they were, not what others thought they should be. They are trailblazers in every sense of the word, making the music they wanted to make, playing it and presenting it in a way never seen before in country music. Introducing rock style guitars, lights, pyrotechnics, sounds that are ingrained in our hearts as fans and what we know as Alabama and great country music, but at the time was completely out of left field for many in the country audience. and in an original approach that ruffled more than a few feathers. When you say, guys, it was not everybody was, you know, singing your praises, but now they all are. Yeah, many know that from a long time ago. But they're so ingrained, like I said, and they just changed the game 100%. Like I said, they're the biggest band in country music history. And, you know, they just set a record right across the street. And with that incredible history, they're still out there killing it. They're still doing sold-out shows every night. 3 sold-out shows right there at our beautiful Symphony Center right across the street there. That was a record-setting event. And one of the things that really struck me about the way they ruffled feathers was a story that one of the guys told when we were backstage at the show. There was a concert in the early stage of their career, and they were really blowing up big. And a big concert promoter came backstage before their show, and they asked them, "When are you putting your country music suits on?" "Yeah, when are y'all getting dressed?" Well, these guys, again, they've done it their way, and that's why they are so near and dear to all of our hearts. I mean, and they have influenced an amazing array of artists. I mean, again, I could list these all day long, but from Ed Sheeran to Jason Aldean, I mean, the list just goes on and on forever. And, you know, this band has created an inspiring pathway that countless other artists have benefited from. It's very fitting that they're being honored as part of this pathway. Although they are proudly from Fort Payne, Alabama, and reside there to this day, the city of Nashville and its thriving hive of music-loving people played an integral role in shaping this band's destiny. There is no doubt this iconic band left an indelible mark on Nashville as well. Congratulations, guys, and I can think of no better way of celebrating what you have meant to Nashville and what Nashville has meant to the legendary band Alabama than being placed in the Nashville Walk of Fame. So come on up and get your
awards over the years that you probably think we're tired of it, but never. This is a great honor to be added to the Walk of Fame, and I just want to say to our fans and everybody we've worked with that was positive in our career, a great big thank you. Teddy?
First of all, I thank these two guys here, because without them, I wouldn't be on the tent today. If I got here at all, I'd be standing out there with those folks in the sunshine. But I appreciate y'all being here today. But just thank the Lord for being raised in a country where you can start out with nothing. And the first high school band I played with, by the way, Sam, we did about half of your stuff. It was a little soul band, and that's where I kept my teeth on playing bass. And later on, fortunate enough to join up with these two guys, and Jeff did the other half. Anyway, it's such an honor to be here today, and for our children and grandchildren, that I've got my first great-grandchild, and they're just as good as the first one. So anyway, for the folks down the road, they say once they put it in concrete out here, they won't take it up, so I hope not. Thank y'all very much.
Thank y'all very much, and special thanks especially to the fans and people that I wish that you could understand the thankfulness that we feel in our hearts. Everybody that all across the country that we get a chance to play for. This last weekend we was in Houston, Texas, and Biloxi, Mississippi, and Augusta, Georgia's coming up. They're all over the country. We're going to Canada this year. We're excited about that. It's been a while since we've been to Canada. So thank y'all very much. And I just, to be on the same stage with Sam and Connie is really a real special thing. And I want to, from this little podium, I want to say hello to my little granddaughter, Stella Grace, that's sitting right here. And my other three could not be here because that's another subject. I thought this was important, but school, I guess, is more important. Anyway, thank y'all. Thank our mayor, and thanks to the city of Nashville, Tennessee. Even though I don't know my way around, I get lost. Anymore, I don't know where I'm going. Used to be when we first came here, we stayed in the lowest rent motel. And we still do. So, thank you very much.